guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Blessing, and you are about to be blessed by Blessing, okay? If this is your first time here, please do not forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Hit that notification button as well while you're at it. So, let's get straight to business. Oh, first, before we go to business, I know you're seeing my makeup and my nice, colorful, bright face, of course. Don't worry, I got you, sis. The tutorial for this makeup look will be live on Sunday. So, back to the matter, okay? So, yes, on my YouTube channel, I'm always talking about blending. And that, I'm always saying, is the key to a flawless, amazing makeup look. So, today we're going to be talking about a very, very important major part when it comes to blending. And that's what? Brushes. Yes, brushes. Of course, I'm always talking about blending, blend, blend, blend. But if you don't have the right tool to blend, I mean, that's like doing a hard work for no reason. So I don't want to see you being stressed out, okay, my sister? I don't like any stress for you. So I'm gonna show you the ropes. I'm gonna let you know what brushes to use for the right thing. When you're using the right thing for the right job, it makes the job a lot faster, a lot easier, and effortless. So let's get into the business, okay? So the first brush is this blending brush. It's very, very soft. The bristles are very, very soft and fluffy, and this helps the soft bristles actually help when it comes to blending the eyeshadow. So this is what you use when you want to have your transition color, when you want to blend out the colors at the top or whatever. This brush is so good and helps to make sure that your eyeshadow look is amazing, okay? You need to have this. The next brush is dense brush, okay? This brush is good for your crease, for packing on colors on your crease and your outer corners. Like, you're gonna see me use this same particular brush in my next video on Sunday. I actually used this brush to achieve my eye look. So this brush is very, very dense. It's shorter than the brush I shared with you earlier. It's shorter, it's not as fluffy, and this helps to pack on the colors on your crease. It's the bomb, okay? You have to have this brush in your makeup bag, okay? So the next brush is a very, very nice flat brush. This brush is actually used for your eyelid. So if you want to put color, add color like I have on my eyelid, this brush actually helps to pick up the eyeshadow that you want, especially, you know, the glittery one, the matte one, the glittery ones. I could never say that word. Do you guys have that one word that you just don't know how to pronounce properly? Yeah, glittery is part of it. I actually said that perfectly. Okay, glittery is part of it for me. So this brush is very, very flat, so it helps to pick up the eyeshadow and it helps to apply on effortlessly. You have to have this brush. Honestly, you just have to. Take my word for it. Actually, this brush is actually multi-purpose because you can actually use the same particular brush to shaping your eyebrows. Disclaimer, okay? These are my opinion and these are what works for me. And I believe it works for a lot of different people too. So I suggest that you try it. If it doesn't work for you, don't kill me. I can guarantee that it is going to work for you. So yes, let's just get into the business. So we're done with the eyes. Those three brushes are essential for any basic eyeshadow look, okay? So now we're gonna go to the face, all right? The first brush I'm gonna share with you is the foundation brush. This brush is actually kind of dense, very similar to the dense brush that I showed you for the eyeshadow. This is very, very nice because it helps to like get the product in on your face. Don't swipe when you're blending out your foundation. Don't do like this. Just tap it in and you will find out that your foundation will actually apply on so much better, easier, nicer. You will find out that you don't have streaks on your face. Everything just It's just better. I personally do not use blending beauty blender for my foundation. I feel like it would actually waste my product. I like using a brush. It's easier that way. It's better that way. I've been using it for years and it works for me. Gets the job done perfectly. Okay, so the next brush is a contour brush, okay? This brush is kind of angled. If you guys can see, it's a little dense, just like the foundation brush, but it's angled. Like, it's not straight. It's diagonal. Yeah, it's not. It helps to contour your face very, very nicely. It makes it a lot easier, especially with the way it's shaped. It just gets your brush in on your cheekbones, hitting the right places at the right time. It's absolutely perfect. The next brush I'm gonna talk to you about is this nice fluffy. This one is actually very, very fluffy. It's very different from the other two brushes that I shared with you guys. This brush is quite fluffy and soft. This is for your powder, okay? It is in a little way kind of similar to the foundation brush, but it's still different. This is a lot flatter. The foundation brush is, let me show you guys. The foundation brush has a round thing to it, but then the powder one is like straight. Yeah, so this helps to get your it helps to get the product right in. When you're applying powder in, just tap it in, the same thing that you're doing with your foundation. Do the same exact thing for your powder as well. Thank me later, sis. The last but not the least is your highlighter brush. A lot of people use different ones. I find that this actually works perfectly well for me. This brush is somewhat flat, is a little dense. You guys can see it's a little. I just use it to apply my highlighter on, so you have that color is on there. This actually helps to apply the product on exactly where you want it to be. It picks up the product very, very well. I like the fact that it's not too big, but it is big enough so I can get it on the surface that I really, really need it to be. Some people use a smaller brush. I don't really like that. I prefer this one because I just feel like the smaller brush is just gonna waste my time for no reason. But yes, so this brushes are very, very important. They are, if you don't know where to start when it comes to makeup, I suggest you get brushes that look something somewhat like this, and you're gonna see a huge difference in your makeup. I'm telling you, honestly speaking, to be honest. There is one more brush that I actually forgot, you guys. I just remembered now. A blush brush, you guys. All right, this brush is very, 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 very fluffy. Very, very fluffy, you guys. You just kind of like just dip this in into your blush and just apply it on your face. It's really, really nice, you guys. And don't underrate it. It looks like it wouldn't really, really get a lot of product on, but trust me, it actually really, really gets the job done. You'd be very, very surprised how amazing this brush can. You see how fluffy, how it's just moving easily? Yes, this is amazing for your blush, you guys. I'd suggest that you get this for your blush. But yeah, so those are 8 brushes, right? If you're just starting off into, you know, getting yourself into the whole makeup thing, I'd suggest not to go in for like the really, really expensive brushes because you're still learning. You don't want to put in too much money, and you know, you're basically practicing and learning. Check out your Amazon. Amazon has so many different things, and Amazon has brushes, you know, that comes in a pack. So I can guarantee that you're gonna get a pack of brush with a lot of the same brushes that I'm talking about. I'm gonna leave the link to where I got my brushes in the description box below. I use a lot of different brushes, but this particular one that I shared with you today, I'm gonna leave that one in the description box below. It's very, very affordable. It's very, very nice. I've used the same brand years ago, and it never failed me. So I would suggest you do that. But of course, if you have a little bit more cha-ching and you're not scared to splurge, I would say try Morphe. Sigma brushes are very, very amazing. I'll say go to Sephora, check out some of their brushes. All right, the last thing is the Beauty Blender. You guys, I have mixed feelings about this, but recently my love for it spiked up again. And honestly, even regardless of if I like it or not, I really, really honestly think that you guys have to have this. Make sure that the Beauty Blender that you're getting is actually a good one. The problem that a lot of people have is that they actually get a fake Beauty Blender. How for you to know if a Beauty Blender is real and fake is the softness of it. You see how I'm just squeezing this? Basically, like, it's literally nothing, and like, it's so gone in my hand. Yeah, if you can do this when it's wet without you feeling any type of pain, then that's good. But if it's really, really hard to the point where it feels like you're hurting, yeah, no, because then that means that when you're putting it on your, when you're tapping your face, you're gonna be hurting. And what's the point of that? Most of the times, those kind of Beauty Blender actually don't even get anything blended well. So make sure that you do your research. A really, really good Beauty Blender brand is Real Technique. Get that at Walmart. Actually, Walmart's beauty section, they have that. You can get it online. I guess 8 brushes that you really, 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 really need if you're just starting off with makeup, or even if you have already started off with makeup and you just want to know, have some more information, I'll say you should try it. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please do not forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. I cannot wait to see you. You in my next video. Until then, stay safe, stay slayed, and stay blessed. Bye.